Hello, my name is Mike, and today I want to show you how to build advanced calculators by taking advantage of Formidable's mini templates. In our last video, we made a quick length conversion calculator from scratch. It was a simple calculation, but it was also extremely simple to set up, thanks to Formidable. Today I want to build a more advanced calculator, but this time I'm going to start with a template rather than from scratch. Templates can be extremely helpful to see how to build forms, even if it doesn't seem immediately related. For example, let's make a temperature conversion calculator that converts between Fahrenheit, Celsius, and Kelvin. And instead of starting with a blank form, we'll start with Formidable's template for a length conversion calculator. Oh wow, this looks pretty complicated, right? But if we check what the form looks like for a user, it's really simple. Toggles for both source and target to switch between imperial and metric, and then a field to put in the number of whatever you want to convert, and then the output. But when we look at the actual form, it's not as simple. So let's see what's actually happening. We have two source dropdown fields and two target dropdown fields. If we choose the first and scroll down, we'll see there's conditional logic to only show this field if the source toggle equals metric. And if we do the same for the second source dropdown, it only shows up when the source does not equal metric. So that means when we switch this toggle, the field is actually being replaced on the form with an identical looking field. And that must mean the same is happening for the target dropdown fields. We also see that this checkbox has been selected for use separate values. And you can see that each selection has a separate value to it, with centimeter being 1 for metric and inches being 1 for imperial, with every other measurement being the number of centimeter or inches it equals. Okay, we're not yet sure why the template has those separate values, but I'm sure it will be clear in a bit. Next, we have two hidden fields. Hidden fields are great when you want to do a little math without it being visible to the user. So this first one is named source metric to inches times quantity. It has a calculation that contains some field shortcodes, and we can mouse over our fields over here to see their shortcodes to help us understand it. So it takes the value of our source unit in metric and divides it by 2.54, which is the conversion of centimeters to inches, and then multiplies it by the number the user types in. Then we have 8 number fields, made to display as big total fields using CSS layout like we did in the last video. Each one uses conditional logic to display depending on what target unit was chosen in the dropdown, and each one does a little bit more math. We could take the time to see exactly what this calculation is doing, but honestly, we don't need to. Remember, we're using this template to help us understand how to make our own temperature conversion. So first, I don't think we need toggles because we're not choosing between options within two different systems. So I'll get rid of those. That means we'll only need one dropdown each for source and target. So I'll get rid of the duplicates. And I'll make sure to get rid of the conditional logic that depended on those toggles being there. Let's add our temperature options here and turn off separate values. Because they're each in their own system, separate values don't really make sense for a temperature conversion. I like the idea of using hidden fields to do some of the calculation, and then using a number field that does a little bit more of the calculation to display the answer. So let's actually add another hidden field. We'll need 3. What we'll do is convert from Kelvin to Fahrenheit, from Celsius to Fahrenheit, and Fahrenheit to Celsius. The other ones will be less fancy math because Kelvin is just Celsius plus 273.15. So Kelvin to Fahrenheit is the temperature in Kelvin minus 273.15 times 9 divided by 5 plus 32. Remember to use the value shortcode or choose it by clicking the three dots. Celsius to Fahrenheit is the temperature in Celsius times 9 divided by 5 plus 32. Fahrenheit to Celsius is the temperature in Fahrenheit minus 32 times 5 divided by 9. Okay, so we have our more complicated math options done with hidden fields. We now need to have all the possibilities for converted values in number fields. The template had 8 because there were 8 outcomes and it was able to pre-convert. We can't, so we'll need 9 values for every combo of source and target field. You'd think we'd only need 6, but we're going to assume that some people will try to convert Celsius to Celsius, because people are dumb. So I'll duplicate the final converted value field, so we'll have 9. Then I'll clean up each one. I'll remove the current calculation and remove the after input field. Because we can't pre-filter in this case, in the conditional logic, I'll need to have 2 pieces of logic that both need to be true. So I'll change this any to all, and then make the source field equal to Kelvin and the target to Fahrenheit. I'll do that for each of the 9 combinations. Okay, I've got each one. Now we need to put in the calculation. So for Kelvin to Fahrenheit, we'll just put in our K to F hidden field value. Done. Same for this one, Celsius to Fahrenheit. We'll just put in our C to F hidden field value. And then for Fahrenheit to Fahrenheit, we'll just put in the value itself, since it won't change. Okay, Fahrenheit is done. Now Celsius. Kelvin to Celsius is just the value minus 273.15. So the short code of the value, minus 273.15. Celsius to Celsius is just the value. And Fahrenheit to Celsius is our F to C hidden field. Nice, only Kelvin left. Kelvin to Kelvin is easy, just the value field. Celsius to Kelvin is just adding 273.15 to the value, also very easy. And Fahrenheit to Kelvin is also easy since we did those hidden fields. It's just our Fahrenheit to Celsius hidden field plus 273.15. And we did it. Let's hit update to save all this work and test it out. There it is, a temperature conversion calculator done quickly and easily. And that's how easy it is to make advanced calculators using Formidable Forms while taking advantage of templates. Subscribe for more form building and WordPress tips, and I'll see you next time.